So it's a really, really warm welcome to what is, in Christian terms, a very, very difficult week. We look this week at Jesus' journey, having come in with such wonderful, wonderful celebration on Palm Sunday. We now look towards the inevitable, which is, as we know, the site of the cross and his death. So we are going to walk this journey together in our minds, in our imaginations. Now, some of you won't be particularly familiar with meditation prayer services. So meditation engages everything about you now. So it engages your thoughts, it engages your imaginations, it engages your emotions and your desires. And Christian prayer, above all things, tries to meditate on the mysteries of Christ. So if you can make sure that where you are sitting is comfortable as possible, and please make sure that you're muted, as I've said, and quieten your bodies and your minds. Stop thinking about lunch. Stop thinking about what comes next. Just be in the here and in the now. So meditation is a way to engage much more deeply in the scriptures. In this form of prayer that we are going to be traveling through this week, I'm going to ask that you place yourself in the scene of the gospel reading, which we hear each day. Imagine yourself being able to see the sights, hear the sounds, sense the smells, the emotions, the energy that's in the story, and use Jesus' story, bring it to life for you. Not something you're listening to, but something you are doing with him through this week. So I've said, please settle yourself comfortably. And now I want you to concentrate on your breathing. I want you to sit and just breathe in very gently. And as you breathe in, imagine that that is the breath of the Holy Spirit of God, just filling all your insides, every single part of you. And as you breathe out gently, imagine that out of the way go all the distractions in the room that you're sitting in, all the noises that are coming to you from outside. And just breathe in gently and out, so that you are quiet and calmed. If you need to go and close a window, then go and close it. Anything that distracts you will take you away from the path that we are about to tread. As you listen to the scripture reading and imagine that scene, focus in, if you can, on Jesus. Day by day, think about what he is doing, what he's saying, and how he himself is interacting with the people around him. Focus on those other people in the scene and think to yourself, what are they saying? What emotions are they feeling? And use that imagination as best you can to engage with the scene with all your senses. What do you see? What do you smell? What do you hear and touch and taste? How is the crowd moving? How are people reacting to Jesus? And how are you responding to him? At the end of each day, we shall sit quietly for the closing music. And after that, we will have time to share with the group what our experiences and thoughts were. And for anyone who is meditating on their own and can't join a group, then sit down and just speak to God as if he was your friend in the room with you, and talk to him about how it feels to be on this journey on this day. So we're going to begin now in this settled, calm state to listen to music which Keith has played for us, and then we will go into prayer. Let us pray. I come, O Lord, with the desire to share the riches of your kingdom and your promise to me of eternal life through the death of Christ, your Son. Forgive me when I forget that the benefits of your kingdom often come only through the path of suffering which Jesus experienced. Forgive me that I confuse your love and your grace with an easy life of serenity, devoid of hardship. I forget that hardships, and in my hardships, you have not deserted me, but you stand even closer to me than ever. As I listen to the words of Scripture, which bring to me afresh Christ's last few days of anguish before his death, open my heart and mind to them, and allow me to share Christ's final journey, that I may also share his final victory. In his name, amen.
Amen.
And so we quietly listen now as Lorraine leads us in the reading from Matthew.
The reading is taken from Matthew chapter 26, verses 36 to 46. Jesus prays in Gethsemane. Then Jesus went with his disciples to a place called Gethsemane, and he said to them, "Sit here while I go over and pray." He took with him Peter and the two sons of Zebedee. Grief and anguish came over him, and he said to them, "The sorrow in my heart is so great that it crushes me. Stay here and keep watch with me." He went a little further on, threw himself face downwards on the ground and prayed, "My Father, if it is possible, take this cup of suffering from me, yet not what I want, but what you want." Then he returned to the three disciples and found them asleep. And he said to Peter, "How is it that you three were not able to keep watch with me, even for 1 hour? Keep watch and pray that you will not fall into temptation. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak." Once more, Jesus went away and prayed, "My Father, if this cup of suffering cannot be taken away unless I drink it, your will be done." He returned once more and found the disciples asleep. They could not keep their eyes open. Again, Jesus left them, went away and prayed the third time, saying the same words. Then he returned to the disciples and said, "Are you still sleeping and resting? Look, the hour has come for the Son of Man to be handed over to the power of sinful men. Get up, let us go. Look, here is the man who is betraying me." Amen.
So we think and pray about the loneliness of Jesus in this story. Oh Lord, loneliness is like being on an island in the middle of a river with no bridge across to the banks. I'm cut off, either because other people have abandoned me or I have abandoned others. Lord, it's more than being alone. Loneliness is being completely isolated and fearful. You sought out solitude, Jesus. You wanted to withdraw and be still and quiet in the presence of your Father. I too have drawn apart for a few minutes here this day. You tried to share your troubles and sorrows with your friends. I too have often tried to share my burdens with people close to me. How did it feel, Lord, when the solitude turned to loneliness, when your friends fell asleep, unconcerned, unable to be involved with your troubles? What did you think of them? I think of my own times of loneliness, of abandonment by those who I felt should have supported me. Times of loneliness inflicted by illness or bereavement. I think of the times of loneliness that have been caused by depression or poverty. I remember how such loneliness feels, how it churns my insides, how heavy a weight I feel hangs over me, how I feel the need to cry, to talk, to scream. I know how hard it is to sleep or eat or motivate myself. Is that what you felt, Jesus? Is that how your friends made you feel that lonely last night together? Lord, did loneliness grip you as it grips me? You understand me so well. You have lived my life, experienced my fears. You have said, as I have said, my Father, if it is possible, may this cup be taken away from me. And you also said, yet not as I will, but as you will. O my Lord Jesus, as I share your anguish this week, let me also share your trust and your confidence that only in the will of God will I find true peace, contentment, and courage.
Let us pray. May the grace of God enable me to share with Jesus in his sorrow and shed my tears for his pain and suffering endured for me. May I feel deep grief as I remember once again the great afflictions that Jesus suffered for me. May my love for my Lord be made real in the never-ending compassion that I give to others. And may I give with the same generosity and gentle loving kindness that he gave to me. Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your disciples, I am with you always. Be with me today as I offer myself to you. Hear my prayers for others and for myself. And keep me, O Lord, in your care. Lord Jesus Christ, you taught us to love our neighbour and to care for those in need as if we were caring for you. In this time of such anxiety, give us strength to comfort the fearful, to tend the sick, and to assure the isolated of our love and your love. Amen. And now I invite you, as you breathe the breath of the Spirit of God in, but as you breathe out, let it be with the knowledge that Christ is within you, and that you may be his embodiment here, so that as you go from one place to another, talking to one person or another, you bring the light and the life of our Lord Jesus Christ with you. Amen. I'm going to invite you to just gently draw yourselves out of the quiet contemplation and allow the sounds all around you to come back to you, so that once more you are in the midst of life, in the midst of community, in the midst of all the busyness of the rest of the day and beyond.